Alright, well, we can only go up from there. Alright. So, like I said, how's everyone doing tonight? I'm good?
Woo!
Here we are on Monday night. You guys are doing pretty well, I think. I had a pretty interesting day. I fell asleep in a Barnes & Noble, just in a public place, fell asleep. And there were people all around me when I woke up. I fell asleep at like 2, woke up at like 4. People around me, they had jobs, they were working, they were doing errands. I woke up and I'm like, man, I have like way too much time on my hands. I'm falling asleep in a goddamn Barnes & Noble at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. School's over now. I'm a student at the U of M, and I've had a lot of time on my hands, but you know, I learned a lot. I took a class this past semester. It was called Environmental Problems and Solutions. It was nice, you know. Basically, the class should be called We're All Fucked. Here's a presentation. We're all fucked. That's all I learned. There's basically every reason that everything can go wrong, we're gonna die. That's basically what the class is based on. So, I made a mistake the other week of working out with someone who was in way better shape than me. That was probably the worst mistake I think I've ever made in my life. So far. We ran 7 miles, me and him. We ran 7 goddamn miles. And then after we got done running 7 miles, it's like, alright, Garrett, you ready for the workout now? I'm like, that was the fucking workout! We ran 7 miles! Nobody was chasing us. There was no pack of wolverines. It was just me running. This dude was insane. After we ran 7 miles, he started to do bench presses. When I run seven miles, all I want to do is lie down, nap, in a Barnes & Noble, preferably. In public. So, yeah. I don't know, I'm doing pretty good overall. I got a girlfriend now. It's sweet. It's hard though, man. It's hard. It's really hard. I haven't been in a relationship for a long, long time. You know, I'm trying to be optimistic about the thing, but you know, that pessimist in me is just getting it. You know? Because the optimist in me is like, the pessimist in me is like, in 8 weeks, you guys are gonna be breaking up and you're gonna be talking mad shit about her in a dark room to a room full of strangers. And I'm just like, that's not true. But the optimist in me is trying to block that shit out, you know? The optimist in me is like, it's gonna be 9 minutes here. Relax.
I think we should wait a little longer till that game is over.
I was at a bar once talking to this girl, and we were just talking, and she asked me what I do for a living, what I'm trying to do, and I was like, I'm trying to get started in media.
Oh, that's cool. Well, have you ever been on TV before?
And I'm like, no.
She's like, well, do you have an agent? Does he like get you gigs? And I'm like, no. And she's like, well, have you at least never gotten paid before? I'm like, no. And basically, through this deductive reasoning, I found out that stand-up comedy is something I do because I can't afford beer. That's basically what stand-up comedy is for me. I knew I was going to be that successful with ladies. In 9th grade, when I was working on a school project, and I got to meet my partner in the project, Annalise Mason, who was the hottest, most attractive girl in the entire high school. And I got to go over to her house, meet her alone. And her dad comes home. She's like, what's going on here? Oh, it's a suit here. Annalise, I'm going to go to the dry cleaning, then I'm going to go to the grocery store, then I'm going to go to work. I'll be gone like 9 hours. You two kids have fun. And I remember thinking, man. This guy doesn't give me his competition for his daughter at all. He just sized me up and he's like, my daughter is never gonna sleep with you, man. You know, wait. I raised her to be smarter than that, bro. Don't worry. Shit. It's true, man. I currently work at Raising Cane's fast food restaurant, for those of you who don't know. What's funny about that is that when I tell people that, They go, aww. People feel more sorry about me than when they find out I work fast food than if they found out that I was homeless. That's true. I don't know what it is. I never can figure it out.
Maybe people are just like, oh, he's homeless, at least he's got his shit together. It's like, oh, he's fast food. How the fuck did he fuck up his bad life? Jesus Christ. It is nice though, people are constantly, like when they, I do think it's uplifting for people. I'm adding that to the world. You're like, what are you doing, man? I work fast food. Oh, I thought I had problems. Holy shit. You just made my day, sir. Thank you. Life's not that bad after all. Life isn't all that bad though. I think we kind of blow things out of proportion sometimes. I know I do that kind of time. I do that in tests, you know? Like high school especially. Every time I failed a test, I thought that was the end of the world, man. Now that I look back, I'm like, when the fuck am I ever gonna need to know statistics? Fuck it, I don't care. It's like, Garrett, you got an F at home, man. Well, I guess I'm not gonna be able to learn how to toast it or make a gym bag. Oh well. That was the end of the world for me back in the day, but I'm getting better at letting the small things go, you know? Letting the little things go. If you guys take away anything in this stand-up comedy performance, is that you should let the small things go in life. Give you an example. One time I was driving, I was late to work, didn't know what to do. I got a flat tire, just out in the middle of nowhere, didn't know what to do. I had a flat tire, didn't know what to do. I just said, fuck it, I'm not coming to work that day. You know what happened? Nothing, because I work fast food. If you don't show up at a fast food job, that's one good thing. They don't care. They'll find someone else to flip the burgers. Anybody can do it. But the small things go in my feet. That's what I think I'm going to try to encourage you guys on doing today. Goddamn, is that Michael Jackson bad? That is. I'll just comment on that for a little bit. It was a good music video. Y'all didn't know this. You know Mark Scorsese directed that music video?
Yeah.
It's true, yeah. See? You learned something today. Y'all think you're just going to know nothing. Now you know the guy who directed Goodfellas. He's got to pay the bills, too. All right, guys. That's my time. My name's Garrett Palensky. You guys are here. Thanks.